I'm going to use Simply Accounting and QuickBooks. Depending on the version of the software you're importing from, you may need a data extraction tool which is available for download from caseware.com. So, starting at caseware.com, to get to the data extraction utilities that are available for QuickBooks and Simply Accounting, we would need to log into your MyCase account. Clicking on MyCase Login takes us to the MyCase Login page where we can hit the Login button. Remember, MyCase provides you with extended access to information and knowledge base items that are available via our website. So once we've logged in to the MyCase account, what we can do is go to Products and select our Working Papers product and look at the latest releases associated with that. Down at the very bottom of our latest releases, you will see our optional components, and this allows us to download the QuickBooks Export Utility as well as the Simply Accounting Connection Manager. Now, for Simply Accounting 2008 and newer versions, the Export Utility is no longer required. But know that you can download it here if you need it and utilize the Export Utilities to bring in the information that you need to bring in. So with that, I'm going to actually go back to Working Papers itself. I have several files that I've created from the GAAP Financials template. Now, these files do not have any trial balance information in them at the moment. And so what we're going to do is we're going to look at some of the different import functions. So first of all, to import data into Working Papers, we need to go to the File menu and select Import. The first item on the top of the list is Accounting Software, and that's where I'd like to start today. So I'm going to choose Accounting Software. Just so happens, the last item I was looking at was Simply Accounting. Now, that's a Canadian edition there, but keep in mind, we also have the Simply Accounting for Windows and Simply Accounting Export options that are available to us. Whenever we choose an import, we're presented with the versions that we're able to import based on that software selection. Here you can see this Simply Accounting version allows us to import from the 2008 all the way up to the 2013 version. We need to specify our import path where the data is located, and then we can choose our import components. Now, with the import components, we have the ability to choose between the trial balance, which will come in to our opening balances, as well as the general ledger detail. Now, this is also going to import our client information if I leave it selected here. At the bottom, this information is dynamic and it does change depending on the import that we've selected at the top. And for Simply Accounting, we would have to specify the client ID in the path that we're importing from and whether we want to bring in the budget data. Quite often our clients will roll forward into the next year in their accounting software. So when you're importing it, you're actually not wanting to import the current year. You want to import their prior year as your current year, and that's going to give you your current fiscal year that you're working on. Also, when you're performing the import, you want to consider whether or not to bring in the prior year balances from your client, because what will happen is if this is not the first year that you've set up this file, you're going to overwrite your prior year balances from last year. So you definitely don't want to do that if you've rolled forward the file. So I'm going to leave it as is. Now, there's other options that are available to us down here as well. You want to go through each of those and make sure you've got it selected so that when you bring the information in, you're getting exactly what you're looking for. Now, every single one of these imports in the list has help built into the Caseware Help system. So when you click on the Help button, it does open up, and it allows you then to go through and see exactly what you need to do to get the data into Caseware Working Papers. And this even has the file names to show you the client database information and the data file information, so you know you have exactly what it is that you're looking for before proceeding through the import. So that's one example